When laser was discovered, it changed not only physics. It actually changed our lives. Lasers have become a part of modern life, telecommunications, medicine, science, and industry. With the new laser technology that my team and I have developed, and we are changing science and industry all over again. Moreover, we are trying to contribute to the energy transition like no other laser technology could do before. But where did we come from? It all actually started back in 1905 with a man you all have heard about. Albert Einstein discovered and explained the photoelectric effect. In 1921, he received the Nobel Prize in Physics for this work, and this was actually a breaking point in classical physics and laid the foundations for quantum physics and finally to lasers. Later, in 1964, the Nobel Prize for lasers went to a Russian-American team of scientists, Alexander Prokhorov, Nikolai Basov, and Charles Townes. But the most important person to inspire me in this life for physics was, whom do you think? My father. My father, Tigran Shmaonov, he was a radio physicist and actually the one who was the first to measure in 1955 the famous background radiation of 3 degrees Kelvin. You heard it right. And he frequently was taking me to his lab, where I was fascinated with the magic of laser light. Indeed, red colors, blue colors, green colors, for a kid, it was fascinating. So, not a wonder I started studying physics at the Moscow University, where my supervisors were the pioneers of nonlinear optics, Sergei Akhmanov and Nikolai Korotev. No wonder again, because nonlinear optics is exactly the science that explains how to create those colors. When doing my PhD on lasers, I happened to work with many more amazing scientists at the institute led by this Nobel Prize winner, Alexander Prokhorov. All since I got fascinated with the lasers at my father's lab, my passion has only become stronger. Now my team and I are working at the Norwegian University of Science and Technology on the development of the new generation of lasers, operating in the molecular fingerprint range. At this point, I think you've got that I love lasers, and I do, but what is the laser? Laser stands for light amplification through stimulated emission of radiation. And those are devices like this one. You have probably all seen the laser pointer before. Laser pointers create and amplify a single source of light. Light that comes out of the laser pointer is one color or one wavelength and doesn't spread out or weakens the way a flash lamp beam would. So you can say you can send the very bright light in a concentrated manner and you can focus this light into a tiniest spot. In the meantime, scientists have learned how to produce many colors at once, up to the full rainbow of colors, enabling energetic and extremely intense bursts of light that last only a few femtoseconds. What is a femtosecond? It is 1 millionth of a billionth of a second. Do not even try to imagine. It's really fast, believe me. Thus, a laser light can be concentrated both in time and in space by the method called mode locking, resulting in highest intensity and strongest fields otherwise obtainable only in stars or in nuclear explosions. We are talking about an ultra-intense and ultra-fast lasers. My team and I have been working on this type of lasers since early 90s and have developed several lasers. And we have made breakthroughs that we believe have the potential to change many sectors of life, including industry, energy, and medicine. Let me talk a little bit more about this new class of mid-infrared ultra-fast lasers that we have developed over the years. To make this laser, you need a special type of crystal called chromium zinc selenide. It has a really beautiful color, like my jacket has. However, the first time I saw this crystal, it looked awfully. It was like an opaque piece of stone. My colleague, Bill Krupke, a very passionate laser scientist and inventor, the leader of the Lawrence Livermore Lab laser program at that time, who just patented this new class of laser crystals, was very excited when he brought this crystal to us back in 1996 to Vienna. And he said, "I believe there is more behind this crystal than just laser crystal." And he was right. It was the first brick in the wall of a new class of ultrafast lasers. It was, as Bill put it, a titanium sapphire of the infrared. This class of lasers would revolutionize real-world applications because it is in the molecular fingerprint region where all life happens. It holds the potential to disrupt and change not only science, but also technology and medicine all over again. It was not an easy task, though, to make this crystal to work at the beginning. But 10 years later, in 2006, the first success came. We could observe bursts of invisible light that was only some tens of femtoseconds long. This opened up the whole era of a new type of versatile lasers that are currently being produced by two companies, a small spin-off company of my research group at NTNU, ATLA Lasers, and the world's largest US fiber laser corporation, IPG Photonics. Sadly, I need to share with you very sad news. We lost approximately a week ago a great person, great personality, the founder and the president of IPG Photonics, Valentin Gaponsev. Valentin leaves behind a stunning technological legacy in industrial fiber lasers and a multi-billion corporation, laser corporation. Including this new class of lasers for which we share the IEEE Snell Premium Award together with Valentin, Sergei Mirov, and Evgeny Sorokin back in 2005. Including this new class of lasers for which we share the IEEE Snell Premium Award together with Valentin, Sergei Mirov, and Evgeny Sorokin in 2005. But let me explain what is so special about the intense infrared lasers that we are talking about. As I mentioned, the ability to emit light at different wavelengths of different colors and to generate very short pulses come hand in hand. And this new class of lasers is truly a champion between all other known invisible lasers. Beyond emitting the shortest pulses, it is also happy to operate at any of its broad range of wavelength or colors, and also change this wavelength by command in a very fast and exact manner. We call this tuning. And finally, they are eye safe, and the radiation can be transmitted through optical fibers as well. So there are plenty of applications. In medicine, such broadly tunable laser sources can be used for surgery, cutting and welding of blood vessels, or for breath analysis. They can empower stimulation of the brain cells by light, so that, for example, deaf people can get back their hearing, or blind people could see again. Since this wavelength region is at the maximum of the eye safety, the lasers can be also used outside of the lab, in the public domain. The laser can monitor the environment and trace gases in the air and in water, including CO2, methane, and other oil-related molecules. It can even trace viruses like COVID in a crowded street. This is a real game changer for sensing. Very recently at ATLA, we developed the next generation of ultra-short pulsed mid-infrared lasers. These are the industrial level, extremely intense and energetic invisible lasers that are capable of modifying many semiconductor and organic materials under the surface in the finest possible way, in a way that has not been possible before with any other laser technology. So it's a true revolution in ultra-fine laser processing. But what does that mean? What do these lasers can do better than other commercial lasers cannot do? To explain this, I need to take a look at the existing use of lasers. And lasers are used literally everywhere, from supermarket to internet connection to your homes or in your phone. For example, the Apple on the backside of this phone was engraved with a similar laser technology developed by the previous company of my co-founder. Our lasers can not only engrave or mark plastic banking cards, they can cut mobile device screens, packaging materials or textiles in a way that does feel softer to the finger. Many semiconductor and organic materials are transparent for these lasers, and therefore they can be used for cutting, welding, and in other ways processing these materials even under the surface. You heard it right. If this floor were glass or a silicon plate, I could have made a complex and very fine structures of different shapes inside this plate without leaving any marks either on the top or on the bottom surface of the plate. It is like a 3D printing inside a solid material. So the next generation 3D printing technology. Lasers have changed the industry before, and they will do it again. It can be ultra-precise cutting of, for example, silicon without touching of the surface. This is needed both in solar cell industry. We could make thin foils of silicon that you can see here without losing material. And in microelectronics and mobile communications, we can do any 3D shape inside silicon with unprecedented precision and speed. Yes, I believe that application of our lasers in the energy sector is the most meaningful way we can contribute to the energy transition, both in the production of solar cells, as well as lithium batteries, about which you have heard a lot in this forum, as well as in oil and gas industry. Without going into details of it, we could microstructure the cathodes of the lithium batteries to improve the efficiency and increase capacity so that your cars could run longer. This process can be applied not only to silicon, but also to other new materials, such as organic or composites, the materials that are in abundance on our planet. In the early days when the laser was invented, one used to say that the laser is a solution looking for a problem. No, not so, no. These examples show you how these new lasers can change the world to the better. Indeed, we are living in an energy transition era, and we are all trying to contribute our best to building the new renewable and clean energy and to save environment. Our laser technology can positively contribute to it. It might only be one brick. But with this laser that we have developed, it is a very solid brick connecting industry and energy sectors, and it might even change our lives in a very profound and positive way. Thank you very much. Thank you.